What's up, y'all? I tried to position this so I don't get this. Where is it? Light, the glare. Where the fuck is it? The ceiling lights puts the glare. You see the, it reflects in the mirror, but yeah. It's all good. What's going on, cast crew? Yeah, it's breakfast time. 10:36 Sunday morning. Yes, in my house, I eat with a spoon. What? I don't got time for that. I know etiquette when you go outside. I ain't got time. Hash brown scrambled eggs. And I bought some, I don't know if you can see it. It looked like turkey. Ooh, Jesus. It looked like turkey, but it's really pork. Wegmans is also, they slice it off. It's the other white meat. I saw them like, because I'm, you know, you say pork and you associate ham, pork, so look, what ham is pink or whatever. Anyway, I wanted to do a Q&A, and yes, shout out to UT Smith here. This is one of the perks of being a member. You get to ask me the shit. How you doing? So we're gonna get into this. Have some fun. I guess it's kind of a breakfast mukbang Q&A. I'm gonna do them in order. Would you prefer personality over looks, or looks over personality? Can we meet in the middle? No. No, because everyone is beautiful in their own way. So what may be attracted to me may not be attracted to another. So honestly, I would do personality because, girl, looks fade. You could get mashed up in a car and then I have ugly and bad personality. No, I'm good. I do personality, but you, damn it. You got, Jesus. But then again, your personality coming through, that brings a beauty. So yeah, personality. Girl. Is there anything you've ever wanted to do, but let fear stop you? Nope. Nah, I can say anything that I ever wanted to do, I've done it. And anything that I've said I'm going to do, I eventually do it. So, nah. Because I know my own limitations and boundaries, so there's nothing I ever set to say I'm going to do that I know that I can't accomplish, if that makes any sense. Yeah. What's the craziest thing you've ever done for love? Stay too long. Bada bing! Yeah, that, stay too long. And my thing, I was telling you, love don't keep me, sex don't keep me. It's stay too long. You could love someone, stay too long. That's my answer. So the thing is, you could love somebody, that don't mean you meant to be with them. I could love you. Love these different parts of you, but don't mean that I don't want you on a whole. I'm just saying. And it's the same for me. It is what it is. Have you ever been out of your comfort zone? If so, what was that experience like? I can't say I have been because I don't, being that I know me, I'm very particular. So I would never put myself in a situation where I know I'm going to be uncomfortable. But then again, you can't predict situations. But yeah, I'm very... I can't say I've ever been out of it because I've never put myself, I mean, that could be a bad thing too. Yeah, comfort, no. Let me think. I'm trying to think like in all aspects, have I ever been out of my comfort? No, I can't say I have been. It's just like, think. Yeah, off the top of my head, no. If someone cheats on you, would you give them another chance? No. Because my thing is, cheating is a choice. And cheating has nothing, okay, I'm with someone. Cheating got nothing to do with me. That's your issue. Because the thing is here, if we together, you not happy, you have two options. You work on it or you go. That's it. If a person cheats there, you're not happy and you're taking it upon yourself to then go and step outside. No. You can have that. Go ahead. Go ahead and have it because obviously I ain't doing it for you. So go ahead. But nah. I mean, that's if I know about it because, I mean, shit happens and you don't know. Look. Cheating. There's like so much. Again, if you're not happy, you go. And if you stay, you fix it. But like coming back from cheating, For me, that will always be in my head. I mean, not even cheating. Should, bye. Go ahead, Bill would be, no. What originally got you interested in your current field of work? Okay. Well, I'm an operations coordinator at my job. Started off as, you know, administrative assistant, move up, above. I mean, I still have administrative duties, but I have more responsibility. I've always been in this field. I didn't seek out. I was an English major and I graduated my first real job, but I started working in college. Yeah, I was doing, I'm having a brain fart. Office manager, yeah, in the same kind of area that I'm in now. And then I moved over to this where I have been now for over 20 years. I don't know, it's just not, because again, I didn't know what I was gonna do with an English degree. I just know, okay, all right, I'm able to comprehend, read, understand, but this is the truth. But what am I gonna do with it? You know, the initial thought was I was gonna be a teacher, but I don't have the I don't have the patience for it. I'm told I'm, you know, I'm a good teacher, but I don't have the patience because my thing is like, if I tell you twice you don't get it, I'm frustrated. Nigga, didn't I tell you? Go to the back of the class. Nah, I just, it wasn't for me. So it's not that I set out for this current field. It just so happened this is how the universe played it, yeah. And I enjoy being in this industry, you know, in the, because all my work has been in the arts field. And I really enjoy it. I love my job. I love the, what's the word I'm gonna use? The freedom, the flexibility, also where I work. It's not just even what I do, it's where I work. Because I could be doing the same thing somewhere else and not be happy. You feel me? But I don't know if you're talking about, I'm assuming you're talking about, because I don't know if you, I don't think you're talking about YouTube as work. Yeah, I don't think you're talking about that. If you are, yeah, sorry. What are some things on your bucket list? Girl, I don't have a bucket, I don't per se have a bucket list. I mean, the thing that I want, well, yeah, well, I don't know, if retirement, is that on the bucket? Is that, because can I say that's on the bucket list? Yeah, that's on, well, that's already happening early. A bucket list is to get a, I don't know if that's a bucket list. Because I want to do, you know, a lot of traveling, you know, when I'm done working, God spare my life. I want to get a, I was thinking about an RV, but then I was like, this is, you know, doing my research stuff. I'm like, there's like one part of the whole RV experience, but I think I'm going to do more research because I think maybe there's an easier way. The whole idea of having to empty out poop, you know, end up... That's just the part that's the only part that freaks me out about RV and watching the cleaning process. But again, I need to do more research on that. But I've been looking at teardrops, the ones you just kept, you know, hook up to your vehicle. So that's something I do. Travel. That's on my bucket list. Because a lot of places in the United States that I haven't been and I want to go. And I don't necessarily want to do, I'd rather just boom, catch up in my teardrop, get on the road, do what the fuck I got to do. That's that. Just travel, just do a lot of, you know, I can say I just have anything that I wanted to do or if we wanted to, I do it. So it's like I don't really have a bucket list or these are things because I could dead tomorrow. What the fuck is a bucket list? I'm dead and the list is still there. No. I just don't believe, you know, a lot of these things. I mean, they say, you know, make the vision, what say make the vision, make it clear, some shit anyway. But it's like I don't know, I don't have a bucket list. I guess your bucket list is considered things you want to do. Yeah, so I just said it. Well, that's like a major thing. I really wanted to, you know, one thing was on my bucket list, going to China or Japan, but now that ain't really up there. This whole, you can keep it. People are like, would you, you're not going to fly no more? I wasn't interested in flying before. Have I done it? Yeah. Would I do it? Yeah, but it's not, I don't know. I don't got that travel bug like people do. I, you know, I grew up fortunate that I went to a lot of places. So I'm like, okay, whatever. Do I want to go to the places as an adult? Yeah. Am I in a rush to? No. I don't know. So for some people, that's like, and again, I guess it's because I've been to so many places in my life and time. It's just not really a thing for me. I want to get to know United States. I was looking at, who I was watching someone the other day? Oh, it's a comedian. And they was doing a tour and they was talking about Pittsburgh. And it was like how it's like a little, it's like a smaller New York. And I was like, yo, I quickly looked up Pittsburgh. It's a 6-hour drive. I'm like, yo, I think I'm gonna drive. Shit like that. I don't know if that's a bucket. I just want to get up and go and do shit. So, yeah. Whatever. Anyway, y'all. T, thank you for those questions. I enjoyed it. Yo, these are one of the perks as a member. You get to ask me shit. Anyway, I'm gonna finish my breakfast. Y'all have an amazing Sunday. See y'all tomorrow in the vlog.